really, the Sumo dying here or the Imp dying doesn't really make much of a difference. And against going in a going viral scenario, it's way better. Got it. Because now this does extra 3 damage. And we don't throw anything with Pierce. Now Swabby does too. Swabby's gonna finish this game. Roll one. Oh, come on, Swabby! Come on, Swabby, we have faith in you, Swabby. We have faith in you, yes! Swabby for the win, that's what I'm talking about. What's going on, everybody? This is Fry. So today we are finally doing Trick Tuna. Now, we've done Trick Mech before, which is the swarm of a lot of small minions, including Teacher, and you're going to be keeping them alive using Camel Cross and Hardy Treat. I've done this with other Hardy heroes, like Ross Bald even tried it with Smash. I have never done this with Neptuna. My big resistance to doing it with Neptuna is the fact that you don't have that extra one drop, like Con Man, like Cheese Cutter. Like even interdimensional zombie, something that's going to be really, really strong to swarm the first couple of turns and buff everything with Camel Cross and keep your genetic experiment growing. Because Imposter is pretty weak, Ducky is also a pretty weak card. What are you going to run? Headstone Carver, Gladiator? It's just not things that actually do enough damage, aren't going to be able to sort of be reliant, that we're able to rely upon for our win condition. But decided to finally try the deck and revolve it around Toxicc Waste Imp. Here's a little bit of a realization that I had. Toxicc Waste Imp dies to Banana Bomb, it dies to Berry Blast, things like that. But once you're able to give the Toxicc Waste Imp extra health using a Camel Cross, using a Hardy Treat, or using, let's say, Possessed, and this thing has, you know, 4 or 5 health, it is so difficult to remove. I just think, like, Whack-A-Zombie would be the one answer to it, but even, like, a Lima Plurdon in the water does not answer anymore. That will basically keep this around for the rest of the game, and as we all know, if they have a Toxicc Waste Imp on the field, and then you're just spamming Imp Throwing Imp and Imposters, and you have Imp Commander, it's just so difficult for opponents to win, because every single thing, every single one of your Imps are going to be deadly. And you're going to be able to make these fantastic trades. We're also running Sumo in this deck that can actually shove things in, plants into your Imposters and to your Imp Throwing Imps, which anyway is just good in general, because Imp Throwing Imp will throw several Imps, and the Imposter will give you a free card, but especially if they're deadly with the Toxicc Waste Imp, that just becomes really, really overpowered. We are running Imp Commanders to draw cards, so we don't run out of steam in this deck. This also, again, just being a 2-4, potentially deadly, is going to be really, really strong. And running Cowboy as a finisher. This is not only for the Imp synergy, but it also can just be used for that last damage. If you're playing against an opponent that is able to control your early game onslaught, you definitely want to be able to play Cowboy. You can even combine it with Hardy Treat, so it'll actually do 4 damage in each lane. It just gives us a really good backup way of winning, and especially if you can make it Frenzy with Possessed, then this will be a Frenzy Strike Through, and it'll actually be doing double damage per turn. It's actually going to be doing its frenzied attacks in the next lane and then moving. It does it's a really cool interaction. Let's see how this deck does. The idea, again, is going to prioritize keeping your Teacher so you can play your little tricks and your going virals and your superpowers for free. They'll give you a lot of extra tempo. And trying to use at least one of your protective tricks on your Toxicc Waste to keep that alive. And then they're going to have to use a really, really expensive minion to remove really a 2-cost minion that you've invested one small card into. Hope you guys enjoy. Let's get into the game. And we're going to do the prediction thing. So this is our new little thing we do in the live stream over here on twitch.tv/frymup. Come over for the streams, guys. We're going to start a prediction. It'll be open for the next 10 minutes, and you get to predict. Are we going to get more than 7 wins? So 8 or more wins, we're going to play 10 games with this deck. 8-2 or better is a yes, and 7-3 or lower is a no. And you can vote starting right now. Let's go. Okay, so we got Teacher. Okay. Oh boy. Oh boy. Oh boy. Do we just keep this hand with no tricks in it? I probably should have mulliganed for a trick, but can't say I had my wits about me. Alright, I'm gonna play for Neptuna Super. Should I play the Teacher here is the question. It dies really. Thank you, Coconuts Oil. 2,000 bits. Thank you so much. Whoa. God damn. I'm gonna play around the superpower, and I'll just play Neptune as super here. I think 1, 2, 3 could really work here. Does this go in the water is the question. Am I gonna play Toxicc Waste Imp next turn? Against a Kabloom hero. Probably should have mulliganed for a trick. I'm kind of not exactly playing this deck the way I should be. I'm gonna play this on the ground actually and put the Toxicc Waste Imp on heights. On the water, I mean. After the first time we did this betting system. Oh, there you go. I sort of want to play off curve in case this is Cycle Cap. He did pass turn one. So I'm actually going to play Teacher this turn. We don't need the Toxicc Waste Imp yet. The Teacher, I guess I'll play away from the Shrinking Violet. Doesn't really matter which lane this goes in. I guess the Imp Commander wants to go in 4 and this usually wants to go in 3. What's more valuable? A 4, meaning this teacher dying is okay here. It's really okay. So, I'm gonna buff this and just keep the aggression going. I think the, right now that we have no tricks in our hand, the 4-5 is more valuable, but also doesn't get blocked this turn. I know his super can take this out now, and his blow can take this one out. I think we're okay. That's a sumo. So, question is, what is the play here? We could go Imp Commander, that's just the most stats. I feel like the Imp Throwing Imp would play pretty well into Toxicc Waste Imp plus Sumo next turn. Well, Toxicc Waste Imp will always get Berry Blast in. We do want to take this out. Let's just say Imp Commander. Play on curve. Oh no, maybe I should play around the... Well, no, if he's playing Banana Bomb, he's not running Planet of the Grapes usually, so it's fine. This is still a huge threat, this 4-5. He probably doesn't know why we play this on... No! Come on, man! Okay. Alright. So he gets one more Banana Bomb. I don't know if I play my Toxicc Waste Imp here, because it's just a really good target for Banana Bomb. So instead, I am going to play Imp Throwing Imp. And Sumo. We can also actually activate the Imp Commander to hit face here, theoretically. What lane would this go in? I guess we'll put it here, because Imps want to go on the left. Sumo really just works on the ground. You don't play the Toxicc Waste Imp there because of Banana Bomb. Here she blows. That was a good one. Really? Interesting. So do we... I guess the Imp Throwing Imp always does not get hit. I think they played around Pogo. That's pretty smart. So I'm going to put this here. The Imp Commander does make a good trade, and we'll play Toxicc next turn. Opponent's down to 10. Does our opponent have a Banana Bomb in hand? How do I feel like I'm getting sniped right now? Our opponent does have a banana... There was no Banana Bomb played last turn, right? Not at all. So... I still don't play Toxicc. Oh, maybe I should have gone for... I don't know, this is fine. Shrink. Are you kidding me, man? I wonder why he didn't... Oh, because he has the Banana Bomb. That's why... Ugh. Oh, shit played Sumo. This is really awkward. I'm playing this and going viral. What the hell? Here comes the seedlings! Here they come! Here they come, boys! Extra cards, super useful here. Okay. What the hell? I was not expecting this. Survey says number one. Okay. Two. Conjure synergy, here we go.
Banana!
So this wins this trade. Ah, boy. Do I just absorb the banana bomb with this? It's so annoying. But I guess it's fine. Because our other guys do a lot more damage here. Yeah, this is good. We're just going viral. Should be pretty good here. Also blocking. See if that matters. Really? Now nothing hits face. Okay. I think Frenzy here does 5 damage, which is pretty good. So Possessed. Possessed for 5 and keep this alive, I think, is worth it. Okay, he just rolled triple ones. Are you okay, seriously? That's the game. That's the game right there. How did he just roll triple ones? Oh, that hurt. Oh, that hurt. Holy crap. That was so significant. He just has all the answers. So our powers that we have left are, of course, this cost 0. Our powers we have left are blow. We haven't blocked this game. Like, are you kidding me? How many times has he hit us this game? He hasn't even been doing that much damage. How are we down to 3 health and we haven't blocked? He must have rolled some early ones as well, right? But anyway, our powers are blow. Blow does not save us. Encrypt does not save us. And we already used Neptuna, and the last one's Possessed, and that does nothing here, so... Congratulations. That was so unlucky. Come on, man. I'm actually wanting to look back at the YouTube stream real quick. How many times did he hit us this game? He's been doing at most 3 damage before that turn. So he rolls a 1 and a 2. And then a 1. And then a 1, 1, 1. He rolled 1, 2, and the rest were 1s. Come on, man. Bruh. I think one of my neighbors is singing. Alright. Looking for a trick or a teacher. It's so good. Can you hear that? Can you hear him singing? Oh my gosh. This guy's like a rock and roll guy. Okay. And the good news is Spikeweed Sector doesn't really do anything here, so I'm gonna cover this. We'll see if this is heal. We would want to keep this. But I think establishing a lot of early game should be fine. I guess the imp throwing imp really wants to be in this middle lane. There's no shrinking violet or anything, right? The imp throwing imp, you kind of want it to be... You want it to be to the left of your imp commander, but you want it to be to the right of as many lanes as possible. And I'll tell you why. It's because if you have full lanes, 5 full lanes, and this is in lane 1, it's a piece of trash garbage. Oh my gosh, this guy's singing so loud. It doesn't throw anything. If things die in the first 2 lanes and then it gets hit, then it'll throw backwards. I know intuitively you want it to throw forwards, but that's only if you have an open lane. I'm actually scared. You can't hear him? Okay, that's good. You guys actually can't hear him because I have a filter on the microphone to block backup sound, but he's screaming on top of his lungs. It sounds like a death metal, like one of these thrasher guys. What is the play here? I guess we shouldn't really play for blow here because there's nothing you can do. Do I play cowboy? This is probably better. This thing going viral. Huge. It is heal. Rough. That's fine. Only does three. Incredible. Look at this going viral from hell. It's gonna break all the way through here, throw something. Still be alive. You can hear this guy singing through the floorboards. Really weird. It's just blow. We have a pretty solid field though. How is he gonna even come back for this? He's so far away from a heal combo. So most he's gonna be able to do is like taco. He'd have to protect this with a team up. Okay, stalls for a turn. If this guy dies here to the 1-1, I'm definitely not playing blow. The toxic going viral. Is that like a pandemic? Pikachu's fine, he's just vibing.
Pokey pokey pokey.
Where are you bubbling that to? To here so it trades? And then we get a free guy. I'm not blowing. I'll blow later, man. See ya. Oh, that is such a bad play. Okay, we get another imp now. Okay, overshoot time, let's go. The man is running Venus flytrap, ladies and gentlemen. So I could just go for cowboy. I guess cowboy does an extra three this turn. Cowboy blow looks good. Let's go. Hammer time. Hammer is that one. It's alright. That does nothing. Might as well blow it. We're doing so much damage. This is 3, 6, 9, 12. There's gonna be a lot of blocks and stuff, but hopefully like one damage will proc the block. No! 3 procs the block. Come on, man. Rolling though is actually good there. So we're very close. He does not have heal combo. It costs 8 to do the most minimal heal combo. This black hole is driving him absolutely crazy here. Which is nice. Oh! He could have it.
Oh, okay.
See what happens? it just then depends how many little buddies he has. So it does 2 at a time, so we'll block after the first. If he has one little buddy, he can heal for 6 on average. If he has 2, then he can heal for 14 here.
Oh.
But he has no blocks left, so even if he heals for 14, we're doing 9, and we're doing 15. 9 and 6. Yeah, so even a perfect hand, out of these cards, there is a Venus Flytrap Planet, a Heartichoke, and 2 little buddies. Let's be generous. He already used a little buddy, so there's only maximum 3 left in his deck. We still win this turn. It's Especially if he doesn't have the Venus flytrap planet. La 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 la. Oh boy, man's got some water balloons. Don't even mess. Is there a point in doing this? It plays around water balloons for next turn. Not like it's not guaranteed lethal anyway. What are you thinking? Alright. Here we go. This deck's performing well. Even last game. Deck's doing fine. You take a nap and win. Thank you, Terry ONG. Old timer. La 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 la. I don't see this working here. Okay. I don't know about you. I'm gonna try to get the teacher rolling here. They see me roll. Do I use both of them? Is this stupid? Because the teacher is still berry blastable, so I use both of them here. Is this ridiculous? It's also 3 damage to face. I think I'm gonna do it. Ah, rip Rockwall, man. Neptuna's superpowers are really not cut out for teacher. They're really not at all. That's good, actually. I think the Scorch here is fine. Like, it doesn't matter. It just gives us... Waste a card in their hand and gives us 2 cards. As opposed to this, which just does nothing. Okay. Hammer on 3, but, you know. I'll play into that and play around Berry Blast, because every deck has Berry Blast. There's only 2 decks that have Hammer, okay? It's still working on it. Please don't get something really stupid here. Please. Please, 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 please. Okay. 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 Alright. It finally happened. Seedling Brain Nana on turn 3. He has 4 sun and we have 0. How am I supposed to win this game now? How am I supposed to win this game? Oh, that is so stupid. That is so dumb. It drains our brains at the beginning of the turn now. Dear God. Okay. 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 Today's March 21st. Oh. It's 32. Gosh. Yay, I get to play PvZ Heroes. It's fun. I'll just do this and going viral. What did he do on the... He didn't do anything, though. He didn't capitalize. It actually isn't that bad anymore. Oh my goodness. What in heck is happening? Still just takes resources to take this out. Okay, okay. I think I'll take it. Another imposter, really nice. We're actually winning still. Actually. So it's 5. So it's...
2-2-1, I guess. Two. One. And we'll develop this for game throwing up next turn. Imposter from imposter, yeah, it's nice. It just means we have mana. We'll be able to spend our brains next turn. I think PopCab is secretly playing to update the game. Look, we had an update a long time ago, so it's definitely possible. I doubt they're ever gonna make a new set or anything, though. Okay, this is a little awkward here. Both seedlings live now? I guess he's always gonna have a guy, but... Is there any reason to play this? We don't want the seedling to actually move, so I'll just wait this next turn. Doesn't actually do anything here. Nice that this lives. It does get two living seedlings, though. The left one would be the one that would move anyway, so... We want the seedling probably to stay here. Box block. I'm gonna close the window because this guy's just behind me. With both the windows, I'm gonna get my sweater. I like the fresh air of it. Fry! Keep your clothes on, Fry! So what did he get from the seedlings? Oh my gosh, this one was pretty good, but I don't know about everything else. We actually don't have a way to take that one out, which is annoying. Very annoying. The teacher is the one that actually goes here, since it's armored.
Oh my gosh! Brian, you're so thick! Brian!
No, that hurt. Oh, god damn it. Ow. Ouch. Yeah, this works here really well. Slow grows. Kills that, okay. This is a really strong play. Not only activates it next turn, but makes it live. Or, not only makes it live, but activates it next turn. You know what I meant, guys. Extra guy. How did he heal? Another imp throwing imp. Whee! Let's go. I wanna be a cowboy. Really wanna be a cowboy, guys. So this is gonna throw an imp for free. I guess we play this. Should we play for the toxic waste imp? I think an amphibious minion is usually better. There's always swabby, but that's the only bad one. And everything else is really good. Methinks, but this also doesn't, well, that's fine. It also makes this more likely to grow. Looks like it keeps pressure going. And then the second imp's gonna throw it's running just RNG this. Molecale into a 6-drop, survey says. Okay, that's fine. That's okay. And squash. Yeet. So we're getting two imps here. Best case scenario is to throw to 3 and then throw to 5, because then we get extra damage here. Too bad. He's down to 2 still. Survey says. God damn it. Still in really good shape. Do we play teacher? Yes. Just to keep the pressure. I mean, the teacher is useful in an empty lane next turn, but opening that up opens up an extra lane next turn. Only has 3 cards, so... Come on, Swabby. That genetic experiment lives. Mini Ninja dies to the trade, but just makes him have to spend a whole card on that. Really, our opponent doesn't have a banana bomb. They lose. And we win! Easy. Oh, got a nice little crowd here today. With all of everyone's voting. Everyone who voted no is upset that I won. This is gonna make such division in this. I love how it says next to everyone's name, everyone has a blue globe. That means they voted that I am gonna win 8 games. Anyone with the pink globe that says 2 means they voted against me. It's like most of you have a yes, though. Y'all learned your lesson. Is this a good play? It's not bad. Do I hold on to cowboy here? I don't think so. Is keeping 2 of these even good? Is this good enough to keep against Solar Flare? Probably not. This is a strong play. This should be good. I'll just empty mine. Empty my in your mom! Sorry. Couldn't resist. So he has super there, the 50-50. So it's 2-3, I guess? Or 2, maybe. This is pretty strong. That's so annoying. Do I take the 5 damage and do 4 of my own just to set up the imp throwing imp here for the next 3 turns and play into Elderberry? No. Nope. This probably is aggro Solar Flare. Why else is he running Wild Berry? I mean, maybe it's berries. But I like it like this. I like it like this. Cause I like it like that. I probably should have thought a little bit more about the cowboy before putting in the slime, but I think that's fine, because now we have the cowboy in 4. Oh boy! Elderberry that, bish! This is how you really play around Elderberry. It's the line. I don't know if I save the hearty tree for the... I think I'm saving it for this now. So good, okay. Feed me a card, thank you. It is aggro Solar Flare, he just didn't have a turn 1 play. We're in really good shape. That is just... This is going to be absorbing things, filling up lanes. This is going to be so great. The imp throwing imp is now active. Oh, this is just nuts. This is a nuts field for an aggro Solar Flare. We get 3 damage in the water, just putting on more pressure. Very nice. Toxicc Wasteland would have been better, but this is... more than fine. So I could go imp throwing imp here. I also could go just cowboy. I think cowboy's better. It's on curve. Imp throwing imp makes this throw... This anyway covers both lanes, though. Does this play into Elder... No, Elderberry goes here. If he covers this, it goes against the imp throwing imp. Yeah, this is fine. He doesn't know. He's on movement, and he can see it. Oh, this is so strong. We wrecked Aggro Solar Flare. Just wrecked it with a turn 1 super, which is not... It's not easy to do that. The ability of this deck to control with Imp Throwing Imp is kind of cool, especially because it's Neptuna. It's not even like... It's not like even a teleport deck. Get wrecked, man. that was exactly what we wanted to happen. Who's this guy? That Russian name looks familiar. I'm not sure about the Imp Commanders and the Sumos. I haven't really seen it happen yet. I think we have to mulligan for some early game here, especially against Citron. Oh, man. Well, so much for the full mulligan. Is there any point in keeping the teacher here? I guess we're turned like 2-3? I don't like it at all. Do I play the teacher into Galacta here? Yeah, I'll just hold it. Toxicc Wasteland dies really badly to a few things, but... Do we fake the swashbuckler? Well, the imp commander wants to go in 4, so we'll fake it in 3. Even though if we roll a 3, really the imp commander goes here now. It's a little bit sad. We there's a few options we can do here. On turn 4, I could go for these two. I could go for card draw. I could go these two plus the frenzy. This is probably worth it, especially if what he's playing for is a removal card, an actual amphibious minion. This possess becomes really good. Sportuchus. This is a weird possessed. I didn't actually think about the next turn there. We don't actually have a really good play anymore. I think I'm just gonna hold. The atomic RNG. Welcome to the fry, Molly. Atomic RNG. I recognize that name from somewhere. 2 and 2 look kind of cool. We'll probably want to move something away from the teacher here. I like it. Then this makes a good try. Best case scenario is we can move something into the water and make a good trade there. That's weird. Okay, so now we're moving this. What is the play here? I think this is right. I know it does 4 damage to our face, but gotta keep playing cards. Alright. There's a stream I was watching lately that someone said, please RNG, subscribe. I thought maybe that was the same person, so I got confused there. Alright, this is a really, really strong play. It's turn 5. Look at this. I know these, but you know what? They're just gonna give us superpowers. It's really not the end of the world. This is a really, 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 really strong Camel Cross. Insanely strong. I'll probably frenzy those too. Yes, that's what we're doing. Wow, the nut synergy is nuts! It is nuts, folks! Do I even use the blow here? I don't use this. I'm going to frenzy you to kill the mirror nut here. It doesn't die. Even though this does 4 more damage. I hope that doesn't kill us, actually. Wait. No, now it all gets blocked. I was thinking of actually encrypting the teacher. Now when this explodes, our block meter is full. This is the problem with Mirna as a card in general. Never run Mirna because all the damage gets blocked. If this damage would go through and this would actually do the 8-9 damage, we'd actually have a shot at losing here, but it's impossible. The one ghost face, that's bullseye. But now the rest of this is okay, one shot hit, but that's it. Wait a second. Now he's still doing 6 though. Oh. Oh, this actually makes it worse. Wait a second. Do we lose here? We need a roll. We need a California roll, or we lose because of the mirror nut. No, we actually lose. I can't believe it. Wait, no. But if we would have encrypted, then the Sportacus is, man. The Sportacus is just kissed our ass. The blow wouldn't have helped, because what would I blow? If I blow Sportacus, then it's 2, 2, and 2. It's still the same 6 damage. If I blow Mirror Nut, then it does... If I blow Mirror Nut... Then it does 4. Oh, you're right. I should have blown for the 1 in 3. You're right. God damn it. We had 6 health left, so if it would have blown the mirror nut, it would have only been 4. Right. My bad. Misplayed. That's why. No excuses. We can still go 8 and 2. There we go. I wish they give you a couple more seconds to make that decision, but... Oh well. The hell is this hand? More like brick tuna. Got him. I think you just spam 1 here. I mean, it died, like, what do you... Neptuna, again, it could be just be like Primal Peak Shooter, which anyway kind of plays around this. I think we just spam against Neptuna. I think we spam, try to get as much early game damage, and then really rely as Cowboys for the finisher after all the Godifies and stuff are gone. So this should be fun. Soon Swamp, you're too kind. Fume Shroom. Not a bad card there. Might be the best thing. Such good thing! Should be fine. It's called spamming. Spamming McWhamming. See ya! Where am I going viral here? It'd be really nice to get a one drop, because then you like imposter going viral or teacher. That would be really good. Actually turns that into a god. Oh, so good. It's a huge resource. Our opponent did not show us the other card though, right? So Mog Freeze and Weed Whack. We got a one drop though, man. I'm gonna do it here, just play around shrinking. That was not a good Godify. That was a horrible Godify. It was a horrific. Playing around the going viral, that's fine. This is still good. This is only when it hits face it grows, right? Sumo. Sumo activates her. Nice. Whee! Happy St. Patrick's! Sumo Hardy is okay. I mean, Crabboy Hardy. I like the Sumo better. I like the Sumo usually makes a better trade than the Imp. So let's put the Imp here. I'm probably gonna then just give this. This will do 3 damage and be extra to throw as a guy. This is the play. Well, Hardy treat this. See, this would have traded against the 2-2. Now, it loses the trade against the 2-3. That's fine. Bet you're not expecting Sumo Bish. Bishy boy. Bishy McFish boy. So good. What about the block? No, there's no block. That's always good space. I mean, we block, man. Is this a good play? Is this a good play? Is this a good play? I believe it is. It's about as good of an encrypt as you get in this deck. Encrypt actually has... Oh! Ha, here we go! Okay, well, we have enough cards the rest of the game now. Whee! And we got Swappy. Congratulations. It'll just proc the block. It's actually as good as a Toxicc there. Or a Fishy there. Plot. The Sumo activates into this. Really, Encrypt is useless against everything in this deck except exactly the Sumo, and if you have like an Imp throwing it from the field. Basically. Going viral. We'll have 3 draws on going viral here. What? Okay. So the idea is to kill something so this draws. He freezes that. You're so funny, man. So this. Should I play for the going viral, though? Maybe we should play for the going viral. Really, the sumo dying here or the imp dying doesn't really make much of a difference. And against going in a going viral scenario, it's way better. Got it. Because now this does extra 3 damage. And we don't throw anything, but here's... Now Swabby does too. Swabby's gonna finish this game. Roll one. Oh, come on, Swabby! Come on, Swabby, we have faith in you, Swabby. We have faith in you, yes! Swabby for the win, that's what I'm talking about. That's what I'm talking about. Easy! Got him. Yeah, that'll be the highlight intro.
happy days. I still have faith in this deck. We gotta win one more games in a row, but...
No, see, this guy is sniping up Adorni. What did this guy use before? Was it Aggro Solar Flare? Or was it the heal deck? We beat both of them, so I don't even care. Imagine Karen. Do we need a little more spam instead? I don't really know what we need in this deck. I have no... This is probably worth keeping. I think the cowboy is better than this now, but that's fine. Oh snap, it's definitely Neptuna on one. Or should I wait for turn for when we can actually protect it? Maybe this is the play. It's kind of awkward. He also doesn't want to play into it, so this might set up the imp throwing imp. It's really weird, but this is better than Neptuna for 2 reasons. First of all, you want Neptuna with Camel Cross so it doesn't die to Berry Blast. It's a very strong amphibious minion. Second of all, imposter, he doesn't want to trade a 1-for-1 against an imposter, so this makes him make a play into a different lane. As opposed to if we waited for Neptuna, I guess he would still make a play, so it would set this up just as much. Maybe that's not a consideration then, because if we wait for Neptuna, if he has something to spam on 1, does this make him... Okay. That's weird. Seedling. What was this deck again? It was like the control seedling deck. Come on, come on, come on, come on. 1 and 3. Got him. Rest in peace, seedling. See you later. So great. Another 1-drop would be nice. I really might put the Neptuna here now. And like double Camel Cross or something. We'll see what he does. I could also just put it in the water. I could also just go viral here. But that would be a big silly. Okay, so this will have 6 health, -2. It still doesn't die to really anything. Or is it worth it to do 3 to his face? Not really. Probably killing this is better than doing 3 to his face. And then we can just go viral and we'll have toxic waste in maybe. We're not bricked at all. This is the most unbricky hand. We have a field, a very strong field, considered what we're going up against here. And we have going viral. Now we can top deck any 1 or 2 drop, which is 80% of our deck. And actually have a huge play next turn. If not, we'll have a fine play, which is going viral. Just 1 going viral. If we get a trick, it also works. That does not hit. That keep was good, because now it's this 4 damage here. It's fine. A 1 drop? Yeah. Wait. He kept a power, though. Ugh. He didn't use... He used... What power did he use already? Sorry. He used Weed Whack. No, he used Scorch. He used Scorch on the... It wasn't Weed Whack that he used. It was Scorch, right? Guys, remind me. He used Scorch. Okay. So we'll play into Weed Whack and don't have to play around Scorch. Okay. That's a really, really strong... This imposter is insanity right now. This is the one thing. Come on, man. It's going face here. Interesting. We're still doing 7 frenzy. There's teacher. That's nice. This is going all right. This 8 damage here is a little bit harsh, but... Okay, here's the consideration. With the Hardy Tree, this teacher could actually go face this turn. But then we take 8, as opposed to taking 5. It's a 3 damage swing, so it's us being down to 4, or it's us being down to 7. 7's so much more comfy here. This will again have 4. Oh no, this only has 5. Oh, never mind. I just calculated for 10 minutes and something that was completely wrong. This plus hardy plus going viral still dies. Guys, just ignore me. I'm not really that smart. The hell is this? I'm gonna give you coronavirus. Guys, we can roll a double zeros. It's always possible. Play around Berry Blast next turn. Char. Plus this usually hits face, so it's extra 1 damage. Nice. Nice. That's a nice octopus. That's a nice octopus you got there. It's a good one. Another night. Welcome to the stream. Sorry, I'm concentrating so hard in these games. I don't like reading chat that much. Survey says... That was a pretty crappy molecule. Okay, okay. So he does 6 to our face here anyway. Procs are blocked. God damn it. Do I use this? We can't. These are so too strong. There's a situation where you use it, but that's not the story. Okay, so I'm gonna block the damage here, I guess. And maybe that'll... I mean... no. So we need the 6 to go face, but it does. Shrooms. I'll go for the card here. Really? So we're only doing 4 now. This trade works better now than later. Activate the sumo again. Why the hell not? Maybe we'll get it going viral? Oh. Now this does 5. Is this worth it? Or do we do this next turn for some reason? With the sumo? The sumo actually goes face next turn if we save this. Probably an extra card is better. Probably. Hardy treat wins. Okay. That was awkward. It's down to 1. Sim throwing is pretty strong. I don't know if that was necessarily correct, but... it was the next card, but oh well. So we need 1 damage. So we'll go like this. It's nice that we have a gravestone here. I just don't want to get berry blasted. This still is breaking. This imposter is a 5-7 frenzy. It's not okay. Okay. You know what? This hardy treat might just activate the imposter here. Okay, he gets Sky Shooter. It's doing 7. He got Soul Patch. What am I moving? I'm moving this. I don't know. He got Soul Patch. Ladies and gentlemen, the man just got Soul Patch. Don't even worry about it. This has 5, so... Oh, god damn it. So we need... So this dies regardless, but he's going to have 2 imps, so hopefully... Our play right now, our win condition is Ragnaros hitting one of the 2 imps that are spawned here. And then we win here. There's really no point in hardying this, right? I mean, if he blocks... Ragnaros... Well, no, but the Soul Patch still lives. No, we're just... Uh-oh! Okay, so if Ragnaros hits the turkey, we win. If Ragnaros hits the turkey, we win because the Soul Patch dies. Come on! Yes! Are you kidding me? We get Imp throwing Imp, Toxic waste Imp, this has Frenzy, goes face, kills Soul Patch, Toxic still in the water lane unscathed, and we win the game! Wow. Just wow. Just wow. It actually happened, man. Alright, I think we're ending the stream right now. I'm joking. That was incredible. 104. Molecule. The old patch. Imp toxic. So imposter is deadly. Frenzy kills. Soul patch. Current. It's exactly a turkey.
You know how many things, happen there? He molecules into a soul patch. We happen to have this ridiculous just imposter on the field. That's a 5-7. We get exactly Toxic Wasting, which is the only way to kill soul patch that turn. The Ragnar's Berry had a 1 in 4 chance. If it goes phase, we're dead. We're dead on the spot. If it hits the imposter, then soul patch, we don't win that turn. I mean, the Toxic Waste, no, then we're dead on the spot too if it hits the imposter, because the whip vine kills us. If it kills Toxic Waste, then the soul patch lives for the rest of that game. There's no way to kill soul patch, so we might as well automatically concede. The only scenario in which we could even have a chance of winning the game is if Ragnaros went to lane 1 to the turkey, the other minion that we happen to throw from imp throwing game, which we happen to be able to activate and get a second guy just because we happen to get encrypt on sumo last turn. And he happened to get a team up, which is a miracle, or else we wouldn't have been able to shove something into that imp throwing game. And then the Toxic Waste imp after all that is alive, and he could roll 3 and he doesn't and wins the game. That was a perfect highlight. Absolutely glorious. How do you not keep this hand? How do you do it though? Do I get rid of the cowboy and look for a 1? I don't even know what you, I mean, it's 2, 3, 4. When do you play the imp throwing imp? I need a mulligan something here. I can either go for the combo or I can go for the cowboy. I think I just get rid of the imp throwing imp. And we have 2 cowboys, but that's fine. So, I don't know what we would even blow on 1. Keeping the imp throwing up would be good if he, like, spams a bonk choy on 1. It's not really good. Let's see again. He could have a Ligma, but... Or he could have his own blow. It's 5-2. Thank you. We're betting today. We gotta keep track. I don't even know if I go after... this black IP. I think us drawing a card, I mean, it is a good trade. I think us drawing a card is better though. Making more of a threat, and then this cowboy anyway just comes in and kind of clears the town. We're not playing any tricks anytime soon. Oh, he has a big in. He better have a freeze. What was that? Why? Just tell me why. Can someone explain that to me? He just spent 2 really powerful cards, including a superpower, to not kill the imp commander and lose the trade. At least do that in a different lane, dude. I'm sorry, it's going in the fail comp.
Snowdrop. Biggin. Deadly commander. What the heck was that play, man? I don't even know what that guy was doing. I think it's just cowboy, like this. So it kills the... We're gonna play some tricks next turn, believe you me. We have to pull off the frenzy cowboy. I wonder if there's a way to dedicate a... She spends another card. This is gonna draw another card. Okay. This might get supered here, but it's alright. I have another cowboy. Alright. Kills that. Wins the trade. Super kills at 3-3. Okay. Okay, see ya. It's fine. Okay, this is fine. Yeah, I think we just clean up with cowboy treat here. Cowboy usually will get blocked on the fourth shot, so I might as well invest the teacher. And then if he bounces the cowboy, this play becomes way better. And we call to blow something just in case. That's good. I guess I don't want to bounce that back into his hand. I guess I just pass here. I can camel cross. I think camel cross is alright. I don't know, man. I don't want him to have that back. That's fine. Clank. Okay. We're doing just fine. yeah. Just this one? And hardy treat this one? Okay. Alright. This hardy treat blue. It's good. This will likely get hit anyways. I still have an extra minion here. Okay. Okay. God damn. Blow's strong, but if he gets this back, it gives him a way to get back into this freaking game, man. I'd love if we could kill this. It's only 5 damage. And they only has 3 cards left in hand, so let's not bounce a freeze into his hand here. This is fine. It makes us not die to block super. Play this next turn. There wasn't a superpower that would make us win. Nice. Nice down the wall. Sumo. It's gotta be Imp Commander, right? See out of these cards how many freezes he has. Blow Squash does not usually win there either, the 50-50, because he had 3 on his block meter, so average block is 2, 2, and 2. Now we can do this. It's wrong one, man. But we're still hitting face with 3 things, and his superpower can actually only take out 1 at most. He has no superpower that takes out both ways, so it's a win. Easy. Annoying freeze. It doesn't do anything, it's just annoying. Yawn. Let's go. She crapped kitchen sink? I would not suggest it. It doesn't do enough for its cost. We've had a couple good decks with it, but there's a lot better things you can craft for 2,000 sparks. Fruitcake. Swimming fruitcake is 100 times better, for example. Going viral is so much better. Pogo is so much better. Flame face. Ridiculous. Make a pirate deck. Hit Ultimate League every season. Easy, easy. Is this our win condition? Maybe. I like the spam, and we'll just play for the... I think against Rose, right? We're gonna... Ooh, no. I guess we want this one to get goaded well. This is odd. We're weed whacked, or else we can get extra, but we don't have a second plate for next turn anyway. Oh, yeah, I'll do this. Against Freeze, this is really, really strong, so I'm just gonna spam Neptuna's power here. Against Go, I think this is alright. So I think I play Neptuna Super and Hardy Treat here. Well, no, you don't play Hardy Treat. You don't play Hardy Treat because you want that for the cowboy. Alright. I don't have to You don't have to do it, but you don't have to hardy train this either. It's just 2-4. Kind of spamming Neptuna's face early. I just find that's what works. Like, they're usually able to deal with the one key. I'll tell you the thing about Trick Mac or Trick Tuna, same thing. Into, Trick Tuna into Rose is that they're able to deal with the teacher, or they're able to deal with just the toxic, but like, they can always deal with like the one key card, so you can't reliably establish early game tempo. If there's a genetic experiment, they just go to fire or transmogrify. It's easy. This makes us not allowed to play Cowboy next turn, but I guess we don't necessarily want to. It's okay. Just spam. So I find the way to actually play this matchup is spam without tricks, and then use your finisher. So in the Z-Mech, it would be more like Quasar if you're running Binary Stars. In this deck, we have Cowboy. I think we just told this. It's gonna be hard for, like, I guess Cob Cannon. It doesn't really even clear this field, though. It kills the teacher plus one other thing. Plus kills his own guy. Like, he could Mog a 3-2. Okay, we got Weed Whack, which was the best one there. I'd love something that's not Cowboy here. That's really good. I know Shrinking Violet's strong, but well, we have to play into it. We have no choice. What's that? Question is, do we hard treat the goat now? And I believe the answer is yes. Now, our opponent used Weed Whack already and used Goatify. So the things that are left are Freeze and Mog. Play on Starfruit. Maybe there's Hammer, which would have killed the Cowboy. He's not. I don't run Shrinking Violet or any of that stuff. Okay, there's the Mog. So the only thing left is Freeze. So Cowboy is actually safe now, except against Second Hammer. It turned a 2-4 into a 2-1, which against Rose makes basically no difference here. I think going viral is. Oof. This is a pretty strong Cowboy. Well, the viral will be active next turn, even if the Cowboy dies. And he doesn't like Ken, unless he has Lil Buddy Cob Cannon. I'm gonna just spam Cowboy here. It's an empty block meter turn, relatively, too. Sort of. Kind of. Ew. God damn. Control is real. That's okay, though. We're winning in health. At least we'll have 3 cards next turn and a 4-3 on the field. Ugh. That hurt. It's just a pretty typical control Rose with Hammer and Chicken Violet. Yeah. Against the Sand Dragon just wins the game. Otherwise, this is really, really strong. No dragon. Imagine dragon. Wing Nut, you are annoying. I need man, this is just the answer everything Rose deck. So obnoxious. I need this to live. Wing Nut doesn't do the frenzy. Could I just have a Toxic Waste Imp in 2 here? That would be pretty nice. I think Imp Throwing Imp needs a buff. What do you think? Okay, that's pretty good. It means we actually answer this now. Maybe we'll get a pot somehow. Alright. Let's play. Don't play teacher, so we can maximize our input. Get it? We're gonna maximize our Imp. Okay, this guy's so stupid. Is this the last block? That was bad. It's the Great Jukini. I think we're done, guys. I'm pretty sure. Should I play to get another going viral? And make this trade? How crazy is that? The chance of getting another going fire, I mean, we've played a few, so it's not great. We also have a pot of gold in this deck somewhere, so that adds one more card that could get us back into this game. Maybe we just go face here? I don't know. Eh, this could have gone either way. Maybe going face, but I don't know. There's dragon, so we can see. Pot of gold costs 7 now, so. I don't think we're gonna win this one, guys. Especially with the swing not alive and well. There's no way to break through to his face anyway. We're taking 13 here. Looks like we're going down to 6-3. Don't know. So sad. He rolls a 1, we don't necessarily die. Okay, now we do.
It actually is the the ramp Neptuna. He's running a different deck list.
Completely different deck list.
Aha! I will frenzy you to death.
Alright. I'm gonna set in the bets now. Give him my money. Choose prediction outcome. We still have one more game to play, which I will play regardless. But the choose prediction outcome. Wow, 59 said no today. 59%. The answer was no. The answer was no. Enjoy your freaking channel points, you freaking gambling addicted gamers. We did not get 7 wins. We did not get 8 wins today. We might get 7 though. Some people are rich and some people are broke. Sorry, guys. It's fun. I like gambling. Noob, you lose. Okay. Alright. Challenge accepted. Oh, the spam is real. Then you just keep spamming against Tuna, right? Question is imposter or teacher? Teacher is better later. That's fine. You guys know this guy? Everyone's like, yeah. We know this guy. This piece of garbage. He's in every match. Now we have like a turn 3 play 4. The teacher's definitely better later. What is he playing? Do I go teacher viral? Looks pretty good. Teacher will blow viral and we'll do the sumo next turn. I'll bounce that. No problemos. I get a hearty treat. Would I use it here? Probably not, actually. Your mom has a black hole! sorry. Whee! It means he plays that as a 4-4 again next turn, but it's alright. I will turn you into a goat. I think the imposter is better than the teacher there, not gonna lie. Since we have no tricks in our hand. But he don't know that. Unless he's sniping. Which is a distinct possibility. I'll play less into the catch-up mechanics. I think because it makes the bad trade, we go face here. Well, maybe going face for 3 is better. Spamming more is better. We don't really need this to live another turn anyway. Oh, we can make it live another turn. Look what I found, fish! Bishy boy! I'll keep resources in our hand. This way we don't actually have to play Sumo anymore. Toxicc, fishy's fine. Roll 3. Roll 1. I'm so happy about the channel points. Lead wax that one. Amphibious minion of the sorts would be nice. Well, we throw one anyway. We don't actually even have to. Going viral is actually the best because we throw a fifth minion anyway. Never mind. It's like we're gonna have to. Imposter is gonna have to carry us here.
Whee!
Ooh, Commander. Okay. I'll definitely say we spam everything here. Going viral. How do we play this? I wonder if this thing going viral is the play? Or we can go 3-2-1. I'm playing around brain nana. Playing around brain nana. The decision. I'm playing into second shrinking, which is annoying. So do we trade this with the... I'd rather do extra damage to his face here, right? And keep an extra guy for the going viral is better. Work. I'm not watching YouTube chat. That's way too many things to do. Heals, okay. Dragon next turn is rough. Heal count. I don't know if there's any cards that really helped us here. I don't think we do this. Yes, heal combo. Maug, give me ninja or muscle. Yours. Oh no, man. This will do 4 damage, so if he doesn't have a way to protect the... If he doesn't have a way to activate or protect the Heart of Choke, then it doesn't do any damage. I guess that's better. It's winnable, it's tough though. Dragon wins on the spot. That's the... Dragon in 3. We are done. He heals to full health here. Even like Astrovera at this point, we're done. It's really about him having no dragon, no Astrovera, no Heart of Choke combo, because Heart of Choke combo really kills us too, usually. It's about him having the he has 8 cards in hand. This is a little rough. What is he doing? Is he disconnecting? Why? Or is he just roping and being an extra troll? Guy, 7-3! Yes, he couldn't handle it. He didn't have an answer. Listen, his whole hand... I'm just trying to imagine what his hand could have had, because he has another catching mechanic that's ridiculously good. A little buddy at least saves him. Little buddy with any minion behind it heals him. I can't imagine... Taco saves him. I can't imagine what those 8 cards... I probably could write a script in practical cards you run in a deck. Any combination of 8 cards and it not actually win him the game. I also want to count that as a loss. He threw his phone in a lick. Mom took away his phone. Maybe his mom saw he was sniping me and said, "No, that's rude. You're grounded. I'm taking your phone away. Just in the nick of time. Thanks, Mom." That's a good place to end it. We'll end it on a mystery. We don't know what happened. We don't even know. Probably was sniping. I mean, his name was Newbie Lose, so...
probably a sniper, I mean. Just statistically with a name like that. Statistically and how many people snipe this stream.
Mom committed lake throw.
Anyway guys, hope you enjoyed. That was a really fun stream. Peace, this is Fry.